which is really unhelpful because they're crap. Okay. Whoa, whoa, whoa. Whoa, 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 whoa. Hello, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, and welcome back to Let's Play Star Salvage. I'm 7 Foot Dust Bunny, and we are still on the starter planet, essentially. I want to sell off those engines, but I've had a thought of that there was definitely another crashed vessel here. I can't find it on the map, so I think I'm going to have to fly around to try and locate it. I'm guessing it's one of those annoying things that doesn't show up, like the junk storage outposts. And see if I can loot some of those as well, to see if I can get that a few extra bits to really top off our money. And maybe I can buy myself a heavy armor or something that I lost. But to that end, I've realized I've been missing a trick for a while, which as I'm recording quite a few of these in advance, some of you may have already been saying this to me. But I've been thinking I want to open another specialty, which the game did say I'd be able to do at rank 3. But it did say I needed some advanced training to do so. Now, I've then remembered that Nodal DM said I had to come in here and go to these manually to do them. And there is indeed advanced training. So we need to activate some advanced training, because I'm not going to be able to get a set of T3 cores for the base very quickly. So let's see what this does. It says, due to the occasional need for an individual to fulfill more than one role, the UCH created an advanced training regiment that will teach you all you need to know to take on an additional specialty. Activate the advanced training mission to get started. Awesome. Okay. Open your PDA to begin. So we will open the PDA. And was that it? It says, the Zurex Empire have control of this planet. Learning how to deal with them will require advanced combat tactics. Take out 5 Zurex soldiers or Ripper Dogs in order to prove your mettle against these ruthless enemies. Note, it is probably a good idea to salvage some advanced weapons before you try and fight the Zurex. Yeah. Well, I've got the sniper rifle, which I actually think, despite that it's only one shot, actually does quite a bit of damage. The junk rifle, not so much. However, I have got quite a stack of bullets. And, oh, I put a large constructor in here, which I should make sure is turned off. It is not. Okay, in fact, I'm going to access it and get it on a different job, which will be to make some more fuel. Thank you. In the meantime, I'm going to ask this one to make me some bullets, because I definitely have, well, I have some bullets, but maybe not enough. So let's say, how many do we get? 50 a go. We've got quite a lot of casings. So if I say I want, say 10 is 500, 20 is 1,000. So let's say 20. If you can make us 1,000 bullets, I'll be absolutely laughing. Because somewhere I have, well, I have here, a T2 pulse rifle. Now a T2 pulse rifle will do some damage. I just need the bullets for it. I'm sure I already had some bullets somewhere. I should actually check the general inventory for some. I mean, obviously I'm making some in this one, but isn't there an in the ammo repository? No, that's the ones I'm making. In the storage repository here, yeah, there's already 138. So with that in mind, I'm gonna hop around the general areas, looking at probably A bit sluggish here. Looking at one, going to junk storage areas just to make sure I've done them all. And two, looking for that hover vessel. Another good reason to go to the junk storage areas is they are often defended by a couple of ripper dogs or something like that. So that might also be a good reason to go there. So I'm going to drop down right at this one right here before I scoot off and bring you guys back in, because I don't know, this one's fairly close by, so hopefully we'll be able to just use the little hover to see if there's anything interesting going on here. I've definitely looted this one, so I need to change it to looted. Any ripper dogs or anything? No? Okay. So this one, I'm just going to change the name to looted. And we shall move on. But I really want to just have a quick look around, see if there's any ripper dogs here. Anyone going to shoot at me? No. I'll have your giblets while you're here. And you. Thank you for volunteering your parts. Oh yes. Ha ha ha. Alright. I will be going around basically all these. Whoa. Someone is here. Okay. There's definitely someone here. Let's just drop this down quickly. Okay. That was very much a Zurak soldier or something of that ilk. Why am I stuck inside the ship? Alright. There's definitely one here. So now we just need to... Hello? There he is. There you go. One Zurak soldier dealt with. One Ripper Dog dealt with. So that's 2 out of 5. I feel like counting with Sev. That's 1. Two. Oh no. Right. So we'll go around. Oh, hello. Ripper Dog number 3. 3. Right. So I was right, because every time I've been to one of these junk storages, there's definitely been some activity around it. I might need to just shore up this vessel. There's not a lot of protection on the underside, just in case I get shot at a few times. I'm just trying to see. I think I've protected everything, like the fuel tank and the core and that kind of thing. Yes, no, no, yes. Where's the core? I don't see a core. I think it's going to be okay. Okay, so I clearly need to eat something as well, and I'll be moving on. I may end up doing some of this in the little, in my other SV, just purely to save on fuel. But I will bring you in when there's some more action. Okay, so there's actually a Zurax like right outside shooting at the side of my ship right now. So he needs to die. And because we're at another junk storage here. Get out. Get out. There he is. There he is. Man down. Ripper dog death. There's two more ripper dogs I see there as well. There we go. And okay, we've got open the PDA up on the mission. Ah, reload. Okay, I'm going to use the junk sniper rifle for this, because the junk sniper rifle is pretty good if you hit them It's awesome. If you don't hit them, not so much. The junk sniper does quite a lot of damage when you actually hit them. The other one was around here somewhere. And where was Mr. Zurak's scumbag? Because he was like here shooting the side of my ship somewhere. This is the problem, you gotta spot them after you killed them. The new grass is great, apart from finding bodies in it. Okay, so I've given up. Never managed to find him. He's probably despawned now anyway. The Ripper Dog bodies have despawned. Let's just quickly check the side of our ship here. Oh, I keep pressing F4 instead of the thing. Which blocks were you shooting? You know, I've just been repairing this ship. No need for that. Right, so now we need to open the PDA again. Da-da-da! Okay, advanced training. Gathering ingredients to craft medical supplies can take a lot of time and effort, which often would otherwise be better spent elsewhere. Growing your own medical ingredients can save a lot of time and effort. Using a food processor, you can turn ingredients into growable sprouts, which you can then plant in a grow plot. Plant one of each of the following ingredients. Okay, so a fiber, a herbal leaves, a plant protein, or vegetables. So I got a shrapnel shotgun and some shrapnel, which is really unhelpful because they're crap. Okay. Whoa, whoa, whoa. Whoa, 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 whoa. Hey, hoo-ha. Hey, hoo-ha, hoo-ha. There's still another Zurak around here somewhere. Okay, hang on. Bear with me, sir. See what I mean? It's only got one shot, but it does hell of a lot of damage when you get it. Oh, man. Fine, I can crouch too, you know. Where is he? Come on, how can you hit me? Did I get him? I think I got him. I saw the rep go. I think I got him. Where is his body? A spider? Screw you. His body is right there. Ow. No, no, no. Less of that. How many Ripper Dogs are there here? My god! Okay. Change of plan. Keep still. There you go. Okay, good job that deterred the spider so quickly. Haha. Yes. Yes. Right. My Zurak's friend was over here. Yes. What'd you have for me? Coffee. Great. And a Zurak's gun. Not so great. Would have been really nice if you had some fiber. Or something like that. So, for this, I'm going to need, like, grow plots and stuff. Now, why has it not given me a list? If I not... Let me check the quest is actually selected a second, because it seems to me that it might be an issue with the quest here not showing up. Make sure it's my active mission. Yep, I know. Okay, yeah. There you go, it's actually come up now. Medical plants. Herbal leaf sprout. Plant fiber sprout. or a plant protein or a vegetable sprout. So my plan is simple. I think the food I'm pretty sure I left the food processor behind at the base. So as long as the food processor is left behind there, I should have most of the things I need. I'm a bit worried now that I've left them all in the fridge here. But I should have most of the things I need to make myself plant protein, herbal leaves, that kind of stuff. And plant fiber plants. So we'll see if we can do that. I'll get them all made up and then we'll go and move the quest forward. Okay, so the sprouts are making, but I don't need to make all the sprouts because this one right here I can just take and put back down. So I should be linked here to the base. There you go, and now we have an aloe vera sprout and a fiber sprout. So we'll whap down the fiber. We go, successfully planted. Excellent. I'm going to take that back. And successfully planted. And I'm going to take that back. Oh, and I've planted accidentally the same thing. And we'll put that one back. Okay. So now it says craft 30 bandages, 10 antibiotic ointment, oh good god, and 10 antitoxic ointment. You bastards. I don't have that much. Okay. That is less easy. So I'm assuming I have to craft these in my suit because I'm guessing that otherwise it won't count, because otherwise if I just craft it in a constructor I don't think it's going to count. I can check this by just going to the fridge here and I could probably get the fridge or move the bits across to actually. So if I just moved everything across to there and I told it to craft a singular bandage, no, it counted. Okay, so that did count. So now I need to do 29 of those. Oh good lord. So wow, the antitoxic ointment, I need 30 confetti moss scrapings. Are you having a giraffe? So I'm gonna get 29 of these. At least I can get that started. I'm probably gonna run out of plant fiber in here. Let me see if I can fix that. There you go, take that plant fiber. And I might need to get some more wood. I've got... oh, balls. Okay, so it's successfully completed 30 bandages. Joyous. I now have enough bandages to sink at the proverbial battleship. On the other hand, I need a ridiculous number of confetti moss scrapings, which is gonna take me a while to get. I need a lot more herbal leaves to complete that advanced training. I may even in fact have to, at least temporarily, we'll retrieve that and that, and we'll put the herbal leaves. Oh, I've got like 10 herbal leaf sprouts. Okay. So I'm going to take all of those and I'm going to put all of these down as herbal leaves, and that will at least get me going on the herbal leaves while I carry on round and work on the looting. I can see whether I can get some confetti moss scrapings at the same time. Okay, so it's a little bit close here to a junkyard defense gun, but I did find, and this is something I flew over a while back and forgot about, a jerry-rigged defense turret. Now, hopefully this thing can't shoot me from there. This jerry-rigged defense turret appears to be a minigun on what looks like a small grid base. And if I check the core, this is public, so I can even change it to private. And now it's mine. So, I'm thinking I'll have that, thanks. Now, just out of interest, I'm going to check something here. No, I don't see it. I have had mentioned to me by a few people that some turrets, some of these things, have some of the salvage has a perish time on it, which sounds rather strange, but you know, if it does, it does. I can't argue with it. But apparently, yes, has a perish time on it, and for that to be okay, you need to keep it in the fridge. Now, if I've seen any of this, I've missed it. But you know, I'll keep my eyes peeled for it. I'm worried about that gun. There's a laser gun over there, and there's something over here which is a question mark. I suspect, given the fact this looks like it's underwater, this is going to be another fuel tank. This is not a fuel tank. This is a CV. Crash transporter rear. Okay. Do you have anything worth salvaging on you? Let's do this the quick way. I mean, a few people have made comments about me not making use of this as much as I could. But I do make use of it. You quite often just don't see it on camera. But you see, look, there is nothing other than a closet and a cargo pallet. Cargo pallet accessed. Cargo box. More rubbish. Closet. So this doesn't have a lot of really interesting stuff, I'll be honest, on it. I would like to find the closet somewhere, just to see if there's something nice in it. Anything? There is. 2 emergency ration packs. Worth it. Surprising how often they turn out to be worth it. And I could do with some elevators, so I will take those elevator blocks if I can actually hit the damn things. Okay. So I don't think there's a lot else here of interest. So we shall move on. Ooh, well, hello a second. I brought you back in because this is a Rados comms center right here. Now, granted, it's not going to be easy to take down, and I don't know what it has in the way of guns. It's clearly got some. It's got a gun right there, which is going to try and start shooting me. But I'd like to try and take it down if I can. I'm not sure I'm hitting it. Ow. Okay, the problem is, of course, I can't afford to take many hits. What have we got here? Wow, there's quite a few guns there. Ouch. I'd love to keep some of those guns intact as well. Would be the real trick to doing it. I am, no, okay, backing off. I'm not actually hitting it. I'm just taking hits here. Hits I can ill afford to take. So I might have to back off and come around a different way at this. Maybe if I drop down on this side, I can stick me guns out a bit more and get a good shot at it. Problem is, I'm not actually in range. My guns have a 177 meter range, so I'm actually out of range. Yeah, and he is hitting me. And I am out of range. Ah! Yeah, he's hitting me. That's really annoying. I need some rockets. I need some rockets. I've got one set of one rocket launcher on one of the on the capital vessel. I could always fit it and try and grab all the bits I need from there. And just, I'm not sure if I can actually produce the rockets I need, because the rockets I have are all like handheld rocket launcher rockets. Right, so this is size from the damage I've taken there. Lost a block or so. The other thing I was thinking to do was make this a shield, because I can. See, and now if I made this a shield, I might be in with a shot. You know, I can hammer in some rounds on it, let the shield recharge, and find out and go back again. Okay, so what have we got here? We have a lot of medium thrusters. Weapons? We have two rocket launchers, CV rocket launchers. I don't believe they work in atmosphere, sadly. Have an RCS. Have motion sensors. Medical, we have three things marked as medical that don't seem to be anything. A fridge. What you got for me, fridge? Nothing? Okay. That's probably because I probably took it last time. Generator? Nothing. Grav generator? Nothing. Claims to be there, but it's not. One core, doors. Okay. So we do have quite a few thrusters here that would make quite a bit of cash. And I don't suppose you've got, yeah, you've got quite a bit of fuel as well. Oh look, I've got two CV feet on me. I wonder. I've been meaning to do this for a while. Is actually put the foot back in on there. I'll look at that. I'm not sure I got the blocks on me to do it right now. So this is the one I want to come back to. So this we will edit. This is crash capital vessel. This is the one we need to come back to get all the goodies off before we go out and go selling. You know, maybe I can buy some rockets if I go selling. I'm actually going to leave my claim core here, and I'm going to go back and get the CV, and then I'll do some salvaging, and hopefully we'll then head off to the trading station. If I'm lucky, I might find some confetti moss, but I haven't actually found any yet on my travels around. I know there is some down in the more temperate area. I might have to go back and have another look. Okay, so here we are heading towards the junkyard. in space with all our loot, having looted that vessel out completely. Sorry, slight hiccup there. And I've remembered there's one thing I want to do on this possible CV. Before I go and sell the stuff to the traders here. This CV, possible CV as I called it, which we definitely didn't use. If I remember rightly, oh my god, did I pick up my claim core? Oh, the pain and suffering. I did not pick up my claim core. Okay, screw that. I'm making another one. I'll go back for it. So, having made myself a new claim core for now. Yes, there was one thing on this base, if I remember rightly, which the glow lights are telling me, there was a bunch of grow plots. Which would be very nice to have. Do we have any space in this? No. None at all. We've completely used all our space here. Let's see. There's bound to be something I can move across. This and this will be fine. Because I want to take these grow plots. There's an absolute stack of... inventory full? I'm not connected, am I? That's what you're telling me. You're telling me I'm not connected. Did I drop one there? I did. There we go. Don't want to waste them. I mean, because I was tempted to take the ones from my base. But then I... at the same time, I don't want to take the ones from my base. It's handy to have them there as a fallback point. So, no. I'm not going to take the ones from my base. I'm going to take the older elevator blocks, because it's surprising how much I need them. Here we go. But yeah, there's a... if I find another one of these with a similar number of grow plots, I think that's me sorted on grow plots. Because there's 24 there. Anything else I want from this while I'm here? Oh, inventory full, I know. That's just a second. We're going to disconnect and I'll pick up that. There we go. And I might as well have the bits and bobs from the fridge as well. And those bits and bobs, if I can hit them. And the other thing I want is going to be the grow lights, because that will come in handy too. And I'll pick up the core. Because now I should be able to start laying out my garden here, which was going to be in this area, and it's going to be 3x3, but I'm tempted to put another block's worth down here and move this across, so, because this has more than three, so 1, 2, 3, oh goodness. Please stop. That's me now that's full. The perils of all the loot. Okay, can I pick up another carbon block? Thank you. So the thought is to put it actually there. And then fill in another one, carbon, have one here, and we'll have a nice little window here. Something like that. It seems like a plan. Anyway, I'll finish this off and then we'll go over and see what money we can make from the trader. I'll just bring you back in and show you this at the moment. I'm just been doing... Right, let's turn all the things off a second. So what I'm doing here is I've put the grow plots in and I still haven't sorted out access to this area yet, but we'll figure that out. I put a nice little window in the back and I put a door in to try and make it airtight, and I've actually stuck a few extra blocks. Done a few extra repairs here on the outside. I should really have turned the thrusters off just to save fuel, but there you go. Never mind. I've put a few extra blocks in down here, done a few more repairs down to the down this end of the ship to try and seal everything off. However, we're still not airtight. So what I'm actually doing here is trying to make the ship airtight. So to do that, I've initially obviously gone here and I've turned the oxygen on and it hasn't worked. The oxygen level hasn't changed. That and my little O2 symbol down on my HUD next to my helmet and my jetpack has not lit up. So if we press the N key, there's two things we can do. We can show the oxygen, which shows the path the oxygen is taking, and we can show airtight blocks. Now airtight blocks are in green. What this is showing me is where O2 is flowing. So red O2 is bad. It is flowing over here, over here, over here, over here, out this way, and to space, I'm guessing. There appears to be a gap or something there, so we'll just turn airtight blocks off and we can have a better look at it. And we do indeed have a bit of a gap. So what we need to do is, yeah, we'll take the texture as well, we'll hook that in. And I'll probably just put in there for completeness. And now it's flowing this way. And it's flowing through this O2. Which is a little bit of a pain in the butt. Because it means I've got to go outside to figure out where it is. What I'm going to do is I'm actually just going to pop a hole. Which I believe will take me to outside. A deco block there. So there seems to be a hole here somewhere. Not quite sure where that's going. Okay. So that's left me a little bit confused as to where it's flowing. So what I can do to resolve that is at the moment I know I need a couple more O2 tanks. Because I'm going to take some O2 tanks away. So what I'll do is I'll whop a couple of O2 tanks in here, there, there, and then I'm going to remove two O2 tanks over here so I can try and see what's going on. Let's remove you, and this is our hole to space. Okay. So therein is our problem. Right there. So we'll block that up. And I need to block up the hole I obviously punched out in the first place. So I'm actually going to block it up all the way along. Come on. Work. And we'll do it that way. And we'll do it that way. And we'll do that. Now block that up as well. Hopefully we're now airtight, and in fact you can see all the little blue air things in there, so we are now airtight. Woohoo! So we can walk around the inside of our ship without suffocating anymore. Win! Now I'm sure I will lose the airtightness at some point when I start messing around with things. And I'll have to bear that in mind, because what I'll have to do is put these blocks on. I believe the grow plots themselves are airtight. So you can use them as an airtight seal. So once I've got this area airtight, there's two schools of thought here. One is that I use a gap I've provided here down and just have a vent going down through so as I don't have to install another ventilator. Or then there's the other idea is redundancy. So I block these off so they can't put O2 into this area and then put a separate vent in here. And that means that even if this area gets evacuated, the garden remains safe, which would probably be my preferred method. Anyway, now I will go off and sell the goodies. Okay, so I have parked myself as tight as physically possible to the station, and I'm gonna go in and see what I can sell the goodies for. Right, hello, I'm back. And I come bearing profitable things. Into weapons, in service, major salvage. Yes. He was very popular in the army. Right. So, what can I sell you? Wow, advanced constructors are expensive. They don't sell for very much. But medium thrusters, for example, sell for 8,300 each. These sell for 96,000. Still seems a little low to me considering how much they cost to build. But I personally don't plan having a use for them. So with that in mind, I'm going to sell them. And at least for now, I'll sell both these T1 generators. So if I have them on my bar, and I switch to that bar, can I trade them directly to him? Now, in theory, you should be able to. Yes, yes, I can. There you go. We now have 195,000 credits. Good stuff. I can only sell him six of the medium thrusters, so I'm gonna do that. I can sell him eight of the small thrusters. I have no use for small thrusters at all, so I'm gonna sell him that. What else do I have that they might like? CV cockpits are pretty expensive. How many of those do I have? Just one. Okay, I'm not going to sell that off. I have a whole bunch of these. How much are they buying them for? Nearly 6,000. Not as much as I'd like. I'm going to keep a couple, I'm afraid, at that price. Let's have a look what else I wouldn't mind selling. I wouldn't mind selling some of these O2 tanks and even some of the other fuel tanks, because I've got so many. So we'll sell some of those, we'll sell some of these. We won't sell them all. Now the advanced constructor took flux cores, so I'm gonna hold fire on selling it for now. I wonder if they buy like ammo repositories, storage repositories I don't want to sell. But ammo repositories might be worth a bit. I wonder if there's anything else they buy for a fair whack that I'll be happy to sell them for now. I mean, there's no way I'm selling them that. T1 generators, okay, I'll sell you a couple. They're freaking expensive to buy. Their markup is ridiculous. Now, just out of interest, base MS, can I put a deconstructor in this mod on a capital vessel? That's what I want to know. Because that says like base only. Base MS, not sure. Medical devices, shield modulator. I like the sound of these. I'd like to find some. There's no way you're having my polarized hull generator, that's for sure. So what else was it? Fuel tanks, yes, fuel tanks. I'll sell you I'll sell you all you can take by the looks of it. And how many of those can I sell you? I'm gonna keep four of those. What about the O2 tanks? They don't sell for very much, but I'll sell you some of those as well. So we're at around 358,000. Okay. Is there anything useful we can buy with that? Not from you, by the looks of it. No. What about you? You'll buy RCS, I'll remember that. And you'll buy more RCS. Okay. I mean, that's ridiculously cheap. In my book, though, both of those are ridiculously cheap. You know, even a shield generator for an SV is ridiculously cheap. I mean, I'd like, they don't have a buy it for price, so I guess that's why. I'm just gonna double check here again. Okay. You were the guy who did the salvage token things, weren't you? That didn't seem to work properly. Show me your offers, sir. Medium armor. 52 grand for medium armor. It's expensive. Large optronic bridge. 64 grand. I mean, look. With four of these, we could progress the main quest. That's an interesting thought in itself. What about here? Anything particularly useful here? Bullet casings. Heavy armor. For 94k. So basically I'll be exchanging just over one XL thruster for large armor, which I will remind you, we lost two large armor, which is just killer. There is of course the rocket launcher, which would actually be somewhat useful to have, like one of these things, like the there's a rocket launcher homing missile and a rocket launcher, or the plasma cannon and some plasma cannon cells might actually be able to take out the those gun turrets, you see. I mean, I'd have to risk getting shot at myself, but I could possibly do it. Interesting. I will probably get a medium armor. Depending on, right, let's see. Because if I can get the materials I need to finish the quest to get to the next level, I could just go combat and start getting combat armor. And the combat armor is tougher than the heavy armor there. Well, the medium armor is tougher than the heavy armor there. Although, exploration is also awesome because this armor is tougher than what I'm wearing now. And is highly mobile. Really doesn't hurt my food consumption. And I would also have access to things like this. The scout rifle, which takes scout rifle rounds, not quite sure how I make those, and possibly this scout sniper rifle, which sounds awesome, because I am looking at taking on one of those abandoned outposts, so much so that one of the things I'm looking at for that is getting this, because I can't make any shotgun shells. And damage of 290 at close range might be incredibly useful. Okay. So, you are Mr. Garden Dude? I thought you were a medic, but you don't sell confetti moth scrapings, no. You do, however, sell a couple of sprouts, which would probably be useful for me. You do sell some other grow plots, but I'm gonna take my chances that I can find grow plots for those. Yeah. I thought there was a medical symbol. Was that the other side? Yes. Medical Bay. What does Mr. Medical Bay sell? Hello, sir. What do you sell? Ooh. What do these do? A tactical officer. Minus 300 CPU. Really? Master Shield Tactician. What else does he do? A shield tactician maintains the ship's shield, causing it to recharge faster than it otherwise would. Interesting. A pilot. Okay. A quartermaster. A command officer, minus 1000 CPU. I mean, if I had the money, those things are extremely useful. But I came here for the medic. Medbay. Medic! Where are you? Medic! Right. What you got for me? A medical supply crate. A crate of medical supplies intended to be given to medical researchers in the mysterious structure on Risona. Okay. We've only got one in stock. I could keep one. I'm disappointed he doesn't have any confetti moss scrapings. Arse. I guess administration. I might not go in here. Yeah, so. Damn. I was hoping for someone who could give me confetti moss scrapings. Okay, I'm still going to hold fire on that armor. I know it's available here. Here's the plan. I know that there's a whole bunch more stuff on that other planet. You know, the one where we've got another large thruster, which I want to install on my ship. And there's 10 T1 generators there, which is another 130-odd-K. Wow. They should figure out a way to make those bathrooms more private. So I think we'll go and loot a bunch of that stuff, and hopefully I can loot some more of those interesting rare crates that were there, and see if we can, you know, find perhaps some more armor or enough to complete this quest. Anyway, with that, I am gonna say thank you very much for watching. Like and subscribe, as always, and join us again next time when I'll be having a bit of a search around the other alien planet. Thanks a lot.